It looks like quite a glamorous event, so I've tried to get glammed up. Whether I've succeeded or not is another question. I don't know. Let's see. Yeah. Beauty products. I've got a L'Oreal one that tightens the skin and the old neck there, because I'm in my 40s now, it starts to get a bit jowly. Or the other magic trick is not the creams, it's just to have a bit of a beard, to give you a line. You know, magic tip there, you know.
Maybe not for the ladies, but for the men, certainly, yes, that is a good tip. That is a good tip.
I've met some ladies in my time, and it might benefit, to be honest.
How's life going on the Dale?
Life in the Dales is good. I'm not involved in any massive storylines at the moment, so it's nice and steady. And enjoying it, enjoying every second of it. It's been 4 years now, and it's flown, absolutely flown.
Obviously, the show's been going for a lot longer than just 4 years. What do you think it is about this world that keeps people coming back week after week, night after night?
It's storylines and it's good characters, you know. I think there's been a lot of characters in the show that have been there for years and years and years, that the audience connect with it. We've got a great producer who's actually moving on now. She's been brilliant the last 3 years. And we've also got a great cast and crew. There's no egos on our job. Everyone gets on. It's a real family atmosphere, and I think that helps produce a great show. Well, there was a big disaster this summer with a helicopter crash, but more than anything, it was the first year I was in the show, was the live. To do a live show on location with 10 million people watching was amazing. And for my first year in the show, I will never forget it. It was just an awesome experience. Loved every second of it.
You mentioned, obviously, it's like a family being part of the show. Who are your closest friends in that family? Who do you like to spend time with when you're off set?
Closest friends are probably Laurie, who plays Kerry. Fiona Wade, who plays Priya, Rick McCarran and Baskin Patel, and my old son in the show, Luke Roskill, who's gone now, played Sean. He's like a second son to me. He's brilliant. He'll always be part of my family now. There's a lot of pranksters. I'd say the funniest guy on set at the minute is probably Danny Miller. Between takes, he does all different characters. He'll play all sorts of bizarre characters in between takes and have us laughing our heads off. He's brilliant. Him and Kelvin Fletcher, actually, are probably the two real comedians on the show.
Of all the characters on the show, yours is one that I think fans seem to have taken a particular shine to. Why do you think that is? Why do you think fans love him so much?
I think generally he's a bloke next door. I think people can kind of connect with him. He's a very ordinary bloke, you know. He has his down times, he has his fun times. I think generally he's a funny guy, but we've also seen the other side to him. And we all go through that. We're all, you know, different shades of life affect us in different ways, and hopefully that's why people like Dan. I've had loads of things going on last year. I've got lots and lots of stuff going on. Moving house at the minute. It's never ending. I've got kids as well. You know, my stepdaughter, she's got her own band at the minute. So I'm trying to promote those. My son's 16. He's going to college next. So there's always something going on. Yeah, I don't think I watched TV for about 3 weeks, actually. So obviously things are busy at the minute.
I guess my final question. Have you got a message before you leave us tonight for all those wonderful Emmerdale fans who can't wait for more magic?
Just keep watching. It's getting better by the week. Yeah.